Hi, I'm Jessica, and I'm a senior technical writer here at Learning AI. In this video, I'll show you how to use visual prompting to build a deployable model. Visual prompting is a paradigm shift in the field of computer vision. It is a highly accurate and fast project type that enables you to create and deploy your own custom computer vision model quickly. Because of the powerful and intuitive algorithms built into visual prompting, you only need to label a few small areas to get lightning-fast, accurate results. It's important to note that visual prompting works best on smaller datasets of up to 25 images that include texture. For example, you can build a visual prompting model to detect sports players in a ball, food on a conveyor belt, or homes, trees, and land from satellite imagery. Let's get started. In Learning Lens, I've already created and uploaded images to a visual prompting project to identify cell colonies in petri dishes. I need to label an image. Visual prompting models learn from every labeled pixel, so it's important that I label precisely. To make sure my labels are accurate, I'll zoom in by scrolling my mouse wheel. I can also use this drop-down menu to adjust the zoom. The default brush size is too large. I'll adjust the size by using the slide bar. Then draw a few pixels over this cell colony. Now I'll enter cell colony as the class name. I need to label a second class now. Visual prompting requires at least two classes in every image. Having two classes allows the model to understand where one class ends and the other begins, which helps the model create and stabilize the boundaries. Since I only want to detect cell colonies, I'll define the rest of the image as the background to give the cell class some content to compare itself against. The background consists of both the petri dish itself and the table it's on. To make sure I include examples of both these items, I'll zoom out. Like before, I'll paint a small area and name this class background. Now that I've labeled my image, I'll run it. This will start the model training process. The model almost immediately correctly predicts all objects in my images. I can click the prediction toggle here to hide my predictions, and click the labels button to display the prompts to compare. It looks like the model made an incorrect prediction here, which is fine. I don't expect it to be perfect after running the model only once. So I'll switch the class, zoom in to get a better look, hide the model's predictions, and correct the model by labeling the area here. Now I'll rerun the model. All right, the model is done running. I need to display the model's predictions again. Great! The model was able to correctly identify the area it missed last time. I'll zoom out to take a look at the rest of the image. I can also use this hand tool to drag and view the other parts of the image. This looks great. Now I'll check the other images in my dataset. Visual prompting is an iterative process. It's like having a conversation with a model and you're teaching it like a human. There's some back and forth, but it'll get better each time. And after only a couple of minutes and running the model twice, I now have a high-performance model that is ready to deploy. Check out the Learning AI Support Center and community for more information.